This is going to be one of the most controversial discussion videos I have ever uploaded. I know that this isn't the first controversial discussion video I've uploaded here on the channel. I've uploaded plenty, but never on a subject like what I'm about to talk about now. I've never done a video talking about the type of content that I'm about to discuss. I don't like thinking about this. I don't even like talking about this. The only reason I'm doing this video is because my friend Orbital Sigma sent me the article, he sent me the link to the video, and he kept asking me, well, basically begging me to do a discussion video on this. And I told him, you know what? Fine. If you want a discussion video, I'll do a discussion video, but please be warned, I don't like talking about this type of subject. I don't like talking about this type of stuff. I don't like discussing this type of content. I've insinuated a few times towards, stuff like this, but I've never fully discussed it in a video until now. So, before I get to the article at hand, before I read what the article has to say, let me do a quick backstory for everybody. So, there was this couple up in the state of Minnesota. I don't know exactly where. Maybe it says in the article. I haven't fully read the article. I only glanced at it. This video is going to be the first time I've ever read the article start to finish. But anyways, there's this couple up in the state of Minnesota that recently went through a custody battle for their son. The child at question was 6 years old. And the child's name was named Eli Hart. That was the kid's name. His father, Tori Hart, was married to this woman. I'm not going to say the woman's name here because to me, you're not a woman, you're not a mother, you're scum. That's the nicest way to put it. Scum. But anyways, they had a custody battle over the child. The father tried everything he can to get custody of his kid back. And the father was a loving, caring, kind father. Didn't do anything wrong, didn't do no wrong. Was kind, caring, and loving to his son. Seemed like a perfect dad. The mother, on the other hand, unfortunately, was not. She was addicted to drugs, lived a shitty lifestyle, treated her husband like shit, treated her son like shit, treated herself like shit, treated others like shit, was just a horrible, despicable, disgusting human being. She ended up winning the court case. The judicial system actually thought that this woman had enough common sense to take care of her child with no harm, no foul. Well, unfortunately, just a few days later, she decided out of the blue, for no particular reason, no reason at all, except for pure evilness. She decided to get out her shotgun that she had, go up to her son, and blow his head off. That's right, you heard me correct. She took a shotgun to her son, who was 6 years old, pointed it at his head, and blew his head clean off. 6 years old. Let me get to the article. Okay, so the article starts off. Eli Hart's, I'm not even going to say that M word. I'm not going to say her name. Scum. let's just say Eli Hart's scum person had been sentenced to life in prison for murdering her 6-year-old son on May 20th, 2022. So she murdered her son almost over a year ago. She was sentenced Thursday, February 16th, to life in prison without the possibility of parole after being convicted of first-degree murder. Before the judge handed down her sentence, I'm not going to read any of what she said. I'll just play the video here, and you guys and gals can see exactly what she said, and I'll get to this subject in a little bit. Nonetheless, here's the video. This, by the way, this discussion video is protected under fair use, so please do not copyright strike my channel. Do not copyright claim this video. Nonetheless, here's the video, and I'll be right back afterwards.
Scholar, you have a right to speak this morning if you'd like. You don't have any obligation to speak, but if you'd like to choose to speak, now is the time to do it.
Yes, I would like to say something.
Go ahead.
I'm innocent. Fuck you all. You're garbage.
That's all, Your Honor.
Ms. Scholar, I don't know that that's appropriate here.
Sorry, I told you what somebody else can.
What I would say is, the worst thing that seems to happen to parents is to lose their child. It's worse, though, when you don't lose your child to something like cancer or an accident. It's when someone takes that child from the world. What I can't imagine, nobody can imagine, is when the person that takes a child from the world is the one that brought that child in. But that is what the jury concluded you did, and I respect the jury's judgment, and I respect Minnesota's decision about what the appropriate consequence is. Nothing I do would bring justice to this situation. Nothing I do would relieve any of the pain that you caused by doing that. But what is, according to law, the just and fair sentence for what you did is what Mr. Allard said, and that is life in prison without the possibility of parole. So I will judge you guilty of first degree murder and issue that sentence. I will not.
I can't hear you over your stomach
growling. Bottom line is that you are being sentenced to life in prison without the possibility of parole, Ms. Scholar. I'm not going to impose any kind of fine or fees. I will require that you submit a DNA sample. As I mentioned, I'll keep restitution open for 60 days. There's a tagging misdemeanor case. I'm going to dismiss that in the interest of justice. With that, is there anything else, Mr. Alec, you can cover this morning?
No, Your Honor, thank you.
Ms. Rapp, I have to give you the opportunity as well. Anything else?
No, thank you, Your Honor.
Mr. Leary?
Nothing, Your Honor.
Ms. Newton?
Nothing, Your Honor.
Okay, thank you everyone for your hard work in this case.
Yeah. I'll talk about that in a little bit. Anyways, prior to her sentencing, Eli's dad, Tori Hart, and his stepmom, Josie Josephson, I'm sorry if I mispronounced that name, both spoke at points, dabbing away tears. We now have legal closure on this heartbreaking tragedy, but nothing will ever fill the void in the world that Eli left behind. I hope his family can slowly move forward and eventually find some level of peace, Hennepin County Attorney Mary Moriarty said in a statement on Thursday. I'm sorry if I mispronounced that name. So anyways, authorities say that Scum, 29, she's 29 years old. Just a year older than me. I'm going to be turning 29 in October this year. So this Scum is a year older than me. Anyways. Spring Park, Minnesota. That's where this took place. Spring Park, Minnesota. This news article is from Minneapolis News, but this took place in Spring Park. Anyways, she shot her son up 9 times with a shotgun in her vehicle, including the fatal blow to the head, and then hid his body in the trunk. Orono police pulled her over on May 20th, 2022, after she was spotted driving on the rim of her car and had a window smashed out. Officers then drove her home and then discovered Eli's body in the trunk. She was then arrested. Meanwhile, Eli Hart's father, Tori Hart, filed a wrongful death lawsuit earlier this year related to his son's killing, seeking more than $75,000 in damages. Now, before I continue reading the rest of this article, I love the fact that he's taking them to court and suing them for $75,000, but the way the judicial system works nowadays, unfortunately, I just don't see him winning the court case. I know it makes me sound like an asshole, I'm sorry, but the way things work here in the United States, I just don't see him winning the court case. Maybe he'll get something out of it, but you know for a fact that the court is going to, they're going to fucking countersue him, and they're going to take him for everything that he's got as well, which is absolutely disgusting. Whatever little he has left now, considering that his son is gone now. Anyways, the lawsuit says Dakota County Social Services provided services to Eli, with Tori Hart claiming the county and its employees were negligent. Dakota County and two Dakota County employees, Sherry Larson and Beth Daner, I'm sorry if I mispronounced that last name, were named in the lawsuit. Tori Hart had been fighting for custody as his son prior to his death. Tori Hart's now wife, Josie Josephson, told Fox Channel 9, the boy's mother struggled with drug addiction and mental health issues, and despite their repeated calls for help, his biological mom was awarded full custody of Eli before his death. There's an effort to build a memorial playground for Eli in memory to honor the child. Here's the GoFundMe page, and I will put a link down below to the GoFundMe page in the description box below if you want to go donate. Wow. Wow. You know, I've lost faith in humanity so long ago, but this damn sure doesn't help. It's not the first time I've heard of this. I've heard of this happening so many times in the news, where a mother or a father kills their child for no apparent reason. I've heard it so many times. I've heard it so many times that I'm pretty much used to it at this point. Doesn't mean that, you know, it's okay. Obviously, of course it's not okay. This is one of the, if not the unholiest of sins. Killing someone is one thing, but killing a child, to me, that's the unholiest sin. That's the worst sin of all. Killing an innocent child. I know some people are going to say, well, what about the veterans that go overseas and fight the war on terror and they have to kill children? That's a discussion for another day. I'm not going to talk about that here because I know for a fact I would 100% piss a lot of people off if I talked about that here. So I'll just keep my opinion to myself on that subject. But anyways, I'm not surprised she got life in prison. I mean, of course she's going to get life in prison. She killed a child. I mean, duh. But what sickens me about this whole situation is that this woman, she's not a woman, she's not a mom, scum, this pile of scum, this pile of fucking shit, has the nerve to come out and basically say, I'm innocent, I'm unapologetic, I don't give a fuck, fuck you all, kiss my ass, basically. So, you're not sorry for killing your child. You're not sorry for being addicted to drugs. You're not sorry for having mental health issues. You're not sorry for taking your husband's son out of his life to where he'll never have a relationship with his... He'll never have a family relationship with his dad. His dad is never going to be able to see him go through school. Never going to see his son have his first girlfriend or boyfriend. I mean, who knows? But anyways, never going to see his son grow up. Never going to see his son go out there and make a living of his own. Why? Because you took it away from him. I'm innocent? Please enlighten me on how the fuck you killing a 6-year-old child and blowing his head off and shooting him 5 extra times afterwards. Please explain to me how you're innocent. I mean, good grief. If you're going to say that you're innocent of killing a child, of course, I wouldn't do this. I have enough common sense not to, but I guess I could just go out and buy an AR-15 and cause a mass shooting and then, you know, turn myself in and basically say, oh, you know, I'm not sorry for what I did. I feel no pity or no guilt in what I did. I'm happy with what I did. Do you know how much of a piece of shit that would make me? You're innocent of killing your own child. That pretty much tells me that you didn't give a damn about having your kid. You just wanted to make the husband's life miserable. That's all it was to you, just make the husband's life miserable. Fuck him. He took everything from me, I'm gonna take everything from him. Literally, take everything from him. And then when you won, when you got your way in court, because the judicial system is so fucked up in this country, you decided, I don't want my son no more. I'm just going to blow his head off. You know, the fact that you are going to spend the rest of your life in prison, and you get to wake up in the morning and go to bed at night, you get to have a cold shower, you get to have a meal. Granted, it ain't going to be a good meal, but you're still going to have a meal nonetheless. The fact that you can put clothes on, that you can wake up in the morning, put prison clothes on, go eat, take a cold shower, and then go to bed at night. Meanwhile, this 6-year-old that you took out of this world is never going to be able to grow up to have a life of his own. The fact that he doesn't get to have a life of his own and you do in prison sickens me. It disgusts me and it pisses me off. Why can we not bring back the electric chair, man? I miss the I miss the 1920s and 1930s and 40s and stuff. Back when, if you did something like this, your ass would be immediately put on death row. You would fry in the electric chair. And no one would have any remorse or sympathy or pity for you. They would watch you fry and they would laugh. They would fucking laugh at you. You're a child murderer. No one would feel any sympathy for you. None. The fact that you want to tell the judge and the court to go fuck themselves for killing your child? Oh, don't worry, ma'am. Don't worry. Oh, you're gonna get a lot of fucking in prison. That's the worst thing that's gonna happen to you. Outside of somebody, of course, killing you, which I wouldn't be surprised. And I wouldn't even be upset. I wouldn't be upset if somebody killed your ass. There's people in prison that are good people. Believe it or not, there are good people in prison that are serving life sentences or just serving time in prison. You don't think that somebody is going to be willing to serve a life sentence or another life sentence by taking you out of this earth? There's people out here that don't give a damn. The second they hear you are in the prison for what you did, They're going to come after you. Your life in prison is going to be fucking miserable. I guarantee you that. You are going to be miserable. You may feel unapologetic now. You may feel like you're innocent now. I guarantee you within 1 year, within not even a year, I guarantee you within 1 month, 1 month of being in prison, you're going to be crying your eyes out, begging to be let out. They're going to fuck you up. That's the worst thing that's going to happen to you. They're going to fuck you up. Men and women. They don't give a damn. I know I said before, I'm not a fan of domestic violence, but I did say, and I quote, but sometimes there are exceptions. And this is a damn big exception. There are going to be men in that prison that are going to make your life fucking hell. Oh, they're going to get their own. They're going to get a slice of the pie. And you're not going to like it. By the time that you die, your asshole going to be so damn big, they're going to be able to fit a toaster up there. Just saying. You're going to be black, green, and purple with bruises all over your body for the rest of your life. Because they're going to fuck you up. They're going to fuck you up in ways that I can't even describe here without getting in serious trouble with YouTube. If you ask me, though, if I was in charge, you wouldn't even see a month in prison. I would personally, if I was the judge, I would personally ask for them to bring the electric chair back, if they have one. Dust it off, clean it off, shine it up real nice and pretty. Put your ass in the electric chair. And I would do to you what Percy Whitmore did to that one guy in The Green Mile. You know, the scene, people that have seen The Green Mile, my friend Orbital Sigma, I know you don't like The Green Mile, but you know what scene I'm talking about. The scene where they fry the guy in the electric chair and they don't even wet the sponge. I wouldn't even wet the sponge for you. I wouldn't let you die a painful, a least painful death. No, I want you to die the most painful way possible. I wouldn't even wet the sponge. I just put the sponge on top of your head, flip the switch, roll on to, and watch you turn into a fried piece of fucking chicken. I would stand there and watch you fry like barbecue, like hot dog on a barbecue. Oh yeah, the stench will be bad. The smell will be god-awful. It'll take years to get the smell out of that room. But for what it's worth it. Just to see you fucking fry. That's what I would do to you. I would fry your ass. Lethal injection? Nah, you would enjoy that shit. You're a druggie. You would enjoy it. You would actually like that shit. You actually would enjoy being drugged to death. Being shot, having a cop pull a gun on you and put a bullet to your head, nah, that's quick and painless. That's not enough. Sure, it would erase you from history. Well, it would erase you off this earth. What your actions did will never be forgotten. But you dying via gunshot, nah, that's quick and painless. That's not enough for me. I want you to die a slow, very, very, very painful death. You're innocent, huh? Let's see how innocent you are within a month when your asshole gets spread to the size of a toaster. Let's see how innocent you are. Let's see you scream, I'm innocent. Let's hear you scream, fuck you all. I want you to go up to Big Bubba in prison. I want you to go up to Big Bubba, Big Man Bubba in prison, and tell him to go fuck himself right to his face. See what happens. See what happens, girl. Big Bubba gonna go town on you. Physically by fucking you, and physically by beating the shit out of you afterwards. Or he probably beat the shit out of you and knock you unconscious and then fuck you afterwards while you're unconscious. I'm approaching 24 minutes here. I'm gonna have to make another freaking screenshot here just so I can talk about this a little bit more. I'll be right back. It just disgusts me, though, that you get to live and this child is gone. Nothing can bring him back. He's gone. Just gone. Father. I hope he wins his court case, but unfortunately, the way things are set up in this country, I don't see him getting the full amount. He'll get something out of it, but it ain't gonna be the full amount. Not with the way this country is. And speaking of this country, I'm really not surprised that they gave this woman custody over her son, knowing all the problems she has, knowing how fucked up in the head she is. I'm really not surprised. This is the same country that has done this to so many people for decades. Decades. Hell, I could go back 100, 200, 300, 400, 500 years. This country has always been doing this shit. It's not just the state of Minnesota. It's everywhere. Remember Casey Anthony? Remember her? The bitch that killed her, what was it, her daughter, and stuffed her in a garbage bag in the state of Florida, and they found her not guilty, and she's actually roaming the earth to this day, to this very day, she's roaming the earth. She had to hire her own personal security. Gee, I wonder why. I wonder why you had to hire your own personal security. Oh, why? Because you're fucking scared? Because you're terrified that there's people out here that want to kick your fucking head in? You murdered your fucking daughter and threw her in a garbage bag and you were found not guilty because the judicial system in this country is such a fucking joke? Oh, you get caught smoking marijuana, you could serve like 25, 30, 40, 50 years in prison. Oh, but sometimes if you get caught killing a child, oh, we'll just let you off with a slap on the wrist. At the worst, you'll probably receive like probation and maybe 1,000 hours of community service. Very rarely will you actually serve like life in prison. They gave her a slap on the wrist and said, "Oh, you killed your child, threw her in a garbage bag. Not sorry for it. We'll give you a slap on the wrist. You can go. You're just gonna have to do some community service and pay a fine, but you're good to go. Oh, and by the way, when you do go, you might want to hire some security because people are gonna want to fucking kill your ass." I was talking to Shy the other night on Discord, and he was telling me how he hates the United States of America. He hates it here. He hates America. And he so badly wishes that he could get the money and move out, whether that be to Canada, Mexico, or where he told me he wants to go the most, Japan. Personally, I would love to live in Japan too. Sure, Japan ain't perfect. Canada ain't perfect. Mexico ain't perfect. Every country in the world ain't perfect. But I'd rather be in a place that doesn't have as much of a headache as this country gives me. There's so much drama. There's so much shit that happens in this country. And we both talked about this. There's so much shit that happens in this country on a daily basis that just makes me think to myself, God, I wish I could just afford to get the fuck out of here. Mass shootings, politicians being corrupt, law enforcement being corrupt. You have white cops killing black people. Just a whole bunch of things. And then people want to say that America is the greatest country in the world. How are we the greatest country in the world if we keep allowing this stuff to happen? We allow this stuff to happen, and we don't want to do anything about it to stop it. We don't want to do anything to change it. You know, there's times I feel the same way as him. And I hate to say it, but there's times where I've literally thought to myself, fuck America. Fuck the United States of America. What the fuck has this country ever really done for me? Sure, my dad served in Vietnam, and I respect him for serving for our country. But even then, he served in the Vietnam War, a war that we shouldn't have even really been a part of in the first damn place. The whole reason that we joined the fucking war was supposedly due to quote-unquote communism. And it's the only war. Keep in mind, the Vietnam War is the only war that the United States ever pulled out of because we finally realized, yeah, why the fuck are we here in the first place? This is dumb. And we pulled our troops out and we never went back. That's a discussion for another day. I don't want to talk about that. Do I hate my dad for serving in Vietnam? No. I respect him for serving our country. Doesn't mean I have to agree with it, though. Doesn't mean that I agree with the Vietnam War. To be honest with you, I don't really care for war, period. But that's a topic for another day. I just don't like seeing innocent people die, okay? Especially if they're children. I've rambled on long enough here for this discussion video. There's really not any more I could really talk about. Link down below in the description box to the GoFundMe if you want to donate cash money to the cause. The family could sure need it right now after everything that they've gone through and are still going through. As for Tory, I hope you win your court case, but the way things are set up, I seriously doubt it. I hope you and your new wife, I hope you two live happily ever after. And hey, if you ever have a kid again, I hope that your kid grows up and lives a healthy life. And let's just hope and pray that if you have another kid, that that kid doesn't get killed by a fucking psychopath. And as for the scum, you want to say that you're innocent? You want to tell the court to go fuck themselves? You want to tell everyone to go fuck themselves that you don't feel any sympathy? You don't feel sorry for what you did? Okay. Have fun in prison. Although, if it were me, you wouldn't even last in prison. You wouldn't even be in prison. I would put your ass immediately in the electric chair and just watch you fucking fry. I watch you fry like a fucking turkey. Like fried chicken. Like a hot dog on a grill. I would just watch you fry. I would watch you grill. Have fun in prison is all I'm gonna say. Have fun. As for the child, I'm sorry that your life got taken away from you. Rest in peace. Sorry that you couldn't lead a healthy life. I'm sorry that you couldn't live a healthy life. I'm sorry that you weren't able to grow up through elementary school, middle school, high school, get out on your own, and have a family of your own. I'm sorry that that was taken away from you. All because of somebody who brought you into the world in the first place. I don't want to talk about this anymore. Nothing good comes out of it. I don't know if I'm ever going to do a discussion video about a subject like this ever again. I only came on here to do this video because my friend Orbital Sigma wanted me to talk about it. So, here you go. That's it for this discussion. EdRunner Gaming HD, signing out. Peace. As always, stay safe. I mean that wholeheartedly. Please stay safe in these very troubling times in this very fucked up world we live in. And have a great rest of the day or night. And to the scum, enjoy prison, bitch. Enjoy it. Enjoy having your asshole be the size of a toaster. Enjoy having your ass beat every single day for the rest of your life while you're in there. I'm out. Fuck it.
They will find me through the flames, flames that run down through my veins. I will.